持つ道場はイギリス全土に100カ所以上、生徒数は8000人を超える。だから一月の半分をロンドンで、残りを地方の道場で過ごしている。彼は田舎町の小学校にやってきた。小学校の狭い講堂が今日の道場である。ここでも日本で教える通りに教えた。
私は日本の通りに日本のスタイルでもって初めから教えました。最初に座れない人でも座らせてですね、正面に礼して、先生に礼をして、初めてその練習を始めると。それをですね、最初拙い英語でもってね、いろいろ説明しました。1年ぐらい経ってからはね、逆にそれはやめました。とにかくそれはやれと。そのうちにだんだんね、向こうに分かってくるんです。その時点においてですね、説明するようにしました。そうしないとですね、初めからいくら説明してもね、もう絶対に分かってもらえないです。
ひっそりと静まり返ったテームズ川上流ウィンザー付近、空にも川にも灰色が差して、またイギリス特有の暗い冬が近づいた。だが6度目の冬を迎えても、エヌエダさんの情熱は燃えたぎっている。
空手というものはまだまだその誤解されている面もありますからね、そういった点をもう自分にその理解していただく。だからそれがもう3年なのか5年なのか、それだけはやっていきたい。これがですね、その私の生涯においてですね、その一つのですね、その、まあ、イングランドのイングランドのところにですね、そういったその種をまいたというだけでもって、私のその生涯のしたいと思いますので、ぜひそれだけはもうきりやっていきたいと思います。だから今度はまた読みてですね、どんどん広げていきたいと思いますし、もしそれがやり遂げなかったら骨を埋めるということになると思います。
Mukusho!
The following are the words of Funakoshi Gichin, the father of modern karate, and the man most responsible for pulling back the veil of secrecy that surrounded this martial art for hundreds of years. As a mirror's polished surface reflects whatever stands before it, and a quiet valley carries even small sounds, so must a student of karate render his mind empty of selfishness and wickedness in an effort to react appropriately towards anything he might encounter.
Although karate-do is a 20th century Japanese word meaning the way of the empty hand, the origins of karate can in fact be traced back from Japan via Okinawa and China, possibly as far back as 5th century BC India. It was at that time that a Buddhist monk by the name of Daruma is reputed to have traveled from India to China to teach Zen Buddhism at the monastery of Shaolin Tzu, which is the monastery that's referred to in the current Kung Fu series on television. However, he found that the students that he taught were lacking in stamina, both mental and physical, and consequently, he devised a system of physical exercise to strengthen them up. This involved a combination of yoga breathing techniques and indigenous Chinese fighting. And consequently, the monks of Shaolin Tzu became extremely famous throughout China as fighting monks. As the techniques spread throughout the country, they, however, assumed different forms according to the local conditions. In the northern parts of China, where there are many horsemen who naturally developed strong legs, there was an emphasis upon leg techniques, whereas in South China, where there were many boatmen and paddy field workers, there was more of an emphasis upon arm and head techniques. Much later, about the 16th century, these fighting forms had an influence upon Okinawa, which is an island midway between China and Japan. And at the very beginning of this century, an Okinawan by the name of Funakoshi Gichin traveled to Japan to teach at one of the police schools and introduce these techniques into that country. And having incorporated various Japanese techniques into his system, he renamed it karate. It had previously been called kenpo or kung fu because of its Chinese influence. Funakoshi's style of karate was known as Shotokan, and it's this particular style that you will see demonstrated this evening. The Shotokan Karate Center students will be giving the demonstrations, and this is one of the associations within the British Karate Control Commission. The senior Shotokan instructor in Europe is Kinosuke Enoeda, 7th Dan Black Belt, who will demonstrate some of his techniques with Mr. Hideo Tomita, 4th Dan. 7th Dan is in fact the highest Dan grade in Europe, and the grades rise from 1st Dan to 7th Dan. Mr. Enoeda will first of all demonstrate the technique slowly, that's so that you can observe the style, and then at normal speed. The first technique will be gyakuzuki, or reverse punch. Note that the body is relaxed during the early part of the punch, and this enables the muscles to move quickly, thereby creating speed. Tension comes only on contact through a strong stance, a tensing of all the muscles, and a twisting of the wrist on focus. You will see that when the punch is done at speed, there is also a strong ki-ai, or yell, which comes more from the stomach than the throat. This yell assists muscle contraction and gives a psychological focus to the blow. Notice the control that is necessary not to hit the partner. Mr. Enoeda will now show us a series of blows to the face and body at speed. Mr. Enoeda's control is such that even at speed, he can hold his attack just short of contact.
Ding! Ding!
The gyakazuki is used for punching from close to the opponent. When punching from a distance, you need to step in first. The technique is then known as oizuki. Mr. Enoeda will now demonstrate this slowly, then at normal speed. These punches are exceedingly powerful, although perhaps that's not immediately obvious to the viewer because of the control involved. To prove the effectiveness and the power of these techniques, karateka sometimes break wood. Some styles do this more than others, although all of them do it a lot less than is generally supposed. When they do it to demonstrate power, but also to develop concentration and self-discipline and an explosive physical action. We will now have a demonstration of wood braiding by Dave Hazard, first Dan, who, as you can see, is holding a very large, thick piece of wood, which is in fact 3 inches thick, and it is Japanese obichi, which is a hardwood. The part of the fist that he uses to do the breaking are the ends of the first and second knuckle, not the entire face of the fist, but just the ends, so that there is a concentrated point of focus. Thank you, Dave. Mr. Enoeda will now show you some blocks slowly at first. Blows to the face are generally deflected in an upward direction. Those to the body in a sideways direction, either by the forearm or the knife hand. And those to the abdomen or groin in a downward direction. Notice that these are not just deflections, but strikes at an attacking arm. They can, in fact, be extremely painful and be a substantial deterrent to further attack. We'll now see some kicks, and the most basic kick is the maigeri, or front kick. This is a kick with the ball of the foot to the abdomen or the face. The knee lift at the start of the kick allows the leg to swing in a short pendulum and therefore develop speed. Notice that the toes are curled back to avoid injuring the kicker. After contact, the foot is pulled back quickly to avoid being grabbed.
Ding! Ding!
Another basic kick is the yokogeri, or side kick. This can be done as a hard driving kick with the edge of the foot, or as a snap kick. Snap kick. And a driving kick. Possibly two of the most impressive looking kicks are the roundhouse and reverse roundhouse kicks to the head. These require considerable flexibility. Notice the bent knee again, and the quick pull back of the leg to avoid being caught. Japanese names are mawashigeri and ushiro mawashigeri.
Ding! Ding!
The final kick will be the ushirogeri, or back kick, in which one kicks at an opponent attacking from the rear. There is a pivot on the feet, and then you look over the shoulder to see the opponent. This is the only kick in karate in which the upper body does not remain vertical. Ideal situations, of course, are rare in karate, and rarely can one find a situation where one knows exactly what is to be expected. In an unexpected situation, obviously, the karateka has to train to react instinctively and with a sixth sense. In fact, he consciously trains to be receptive to atmosphere and to the movement of opponents so that he can act automatically. This can be done by practicing some techniques blindfold and also by practicing in confined and difficult positions. We'll now have a demonstration of some techniques which are practiced from a kneeling position, sometimes equivalent techniques are practiced from chair positions. The object of this is not that one expects to be attacked in such a position, but because of its awkwardness, it enables one to learn to react appropriately in whatever situation one finds oneself. Mr. Maseo Kawazoe, 5th Dan, will now defend himself against Mr. Tomita's attack whilst in a kneeling position. Notice how he always watches his opponent. Now we'll have similar techniques from a sideways position. Notice the careful judgment of distance. Ending with an elbow strike. Thank you, Mr. Kawazoe and Mr. Tomita. The publication of karate techniques in book form is obviously a very recent innovation, in fact a 20th century innovation. And originally, techniques were passed down by word of mouth with considerable secrecy and personal example. When one's instructor was not present, it was obviously extremely difficult to practice the techniques and to remember them. Consequently, in order to assist students with this, they were combined together in a fixed sequence, which obviously made them easier to remember. These fixed sequences, and there are many of them, are known as kata, and they take the form of imaginary fighting with several different attackers approaching from different directions. Most styles of karate have about 5 basic kata and possibly up to 50 more advanced ones. Some are old, some are modern, and they vary very considerably in complexity and length. Some are fast and some are slow, and there is a variation in the degree of tension. Some emphasize muscular tension, others relaxation, and the range of techniques and the combinations of them vary considerably. In fact, really, they constitute something like a memory bank of techniques. There are many people who practice karate feel that kata is more in the genuine spirit of karate than is modern competition karate, which, because of its restrictive rules and the inevitable degree of artificiality, has an element of unreality about it. In a kata, it's possible to let oneself go entirely and to thoroughly identify with the movement. This demonstration kata will be by Dave Hazard, First Dan, who will demonstrate one of the basic Shotokan kata known as Hian Yondan.
Hian Yondan!
Thank you, Dave. The performance of such kata is obviously physically very demanding and is very fitness-making. They also have considerable practical applications and can be applied to realistic situations. We will now see an interpretation of that kata with the same.
Thank you. special guest of the committee, Senji Naito.
The first movement is a block which is a common factor to all kata and is indicative of the fact that no genuine karate man would attack first. This kata will be demonstrated by Jim Wilson, second dan, who will be attacked by four assailants. Thank you, Jim. Some of the techniques that you have seen so far may seem a little formal and practiced. This isn't in fact so, but do remember that karateka train for an instinctive reaction so that they can automatically adopt whatever particular technique is applicable. We're now going to have a demonstration of defense against a knife attack, and this knife that you're just about to see is certainly not artificial. By the correct use of distance and movement, it is in fact possible to control the movements of an attacker and to lure him into making specific attacks for which one is prepared. An expert can even control the opponent by use of the eyes, almost as if by hypnosis. We would emphasize, of course, that this particular demonstration is extremely dangerous and should only be practiced by experts in very controlled situations. Mr. Kawazoe will now defend himself against an attack by Mr. Tamita.
Chuo! Yes! Chuo! Chuo! Yes! Yes! Ha! Chuo! Chuo! Yay! Ha! Chuo!
Obviously, split-second timing is required for this. Thank you, Mr. Kawazoe and Mr. Tomita. Many people will doubtless think that karate is a thoroughly unfeminine activity, completely unsuited to women. So far as competition karate is concerned, this is very probably so. But the type of karate that we're seeing this evening certainly leads to fitness, a considerable flexibility, and to a gracefulness of movement, as well, of course, as to a capacity for self-defense. Of all the Japanese martial arts, karate is probably the most suited to self-defense. As in judo, for example, there are a lot of grappling techniques which inevitably give the advantage to a physically stronger man as opposed to a woman. In karate, however, it is possible to move in quickly, get in a quick blow, and then to withdraw quickly, because speed is as much as of a virtue as is power. The fact that a woman is also unlikely to attack first also places karate, this self-defense element by a woman within the general ideal of karate. This demonstration will be by Pauline Fuller, third dan, demonstrating her defenses against Ray Kerridge, first dan. Again, judgment of distance, importance, and timing. And an application of an arm lock. From a collar hold. Thank you, Pauline and Ray. The national religions of the samurai warriors of old Japan were Shinto and Zen, both of which have certain things in common. The interior of a Shinto shrine is very simple. In fact, it contains nothing other than a single hanging mirror. The act of worship therefore becomes an appeal to know thyself through which one might ultimately understand others and the world in general. In performing a kata, an expert endeavors to totally submerge himself in the movement and becomes identified with it. To the viewer, it can seem almost as if he's in a trance, although he is in fact wholly receptive to external stimuli. This is a feature of karate which is very representative of Zen. Our demonstration of a ceremonial kata will be to the accompaniment of a Shinto chant. In this kata, you may see something of the genuine spirit of karate. It's almost like watching an art form or Nureyev dancing, and it certainly transcends purely physical exercise or combat. Zen Buddhists believe that there are many ways or dos to enlightenment, some intellectual, some artistic, some physical. Along with Judo, Aikido and Kendo, etc., Karate Do is merely one of the physical ways to a better understanding of oneself and others. Kinuski Enoeda, who is the highest ranking exponent of Shotokan Karate in Europe, is dressed in traditional Japanese costume to perform this ceremonial kata.
Kojo no tsuki!
Seventh Dan Shotokan. You've seen him demonstrate his kata, and you'll now see him apply some of these techniques in an attack, in a defense against an attack by four opponents. Notice the perfect timing and his positional awareness of his adversaries. This is not an applied kata, although some practice has obviously been given to the general sequence of movements, as otherwise there would have been a distinct risk of injury.
よいしょ。よい。大勝。イエイ。
Thank you, Mr. Enoeda. What you have seen this evening is an aspect of karate other than the general competition karate that most people think of. It obviously develops fitness and physical self-confidence. However, there are other less obvious benefits. The discipline of a good club is such that aggressive attitudes are sublimated and even the irresponsible tend to become responsible. A genuine karate man is the very last person to go looking for trouble. However, quite obviously, many of the techniques that you have seen in this program are extremely dangerous and should only be practiced under expert instruction. So if you wish to take up karate, make sure that you join a good club. There are many clubs around which are not recognized and where the standard of instruction is inferior, irresponsible, and very costly. Unfortunately, the present popularity of karate and kung fu has caused many unqualified people to advertise as instructors simply in order to make a lot of money very quickly. Regrettably, at the present time, there is no legal means of preventing this. So if you do wish to find a good Shotokan karate club, which is in membership of the British Karate Control Commission, write to Mr. C. Hepburn, Shotokan Karate Centre, 5 Darley Road, Manchester, M16ODG, and enclose a stamped addressed envelope. He will provide you with the addresses of clubs in your vicinity. I'll repeat that address. Mr. C. Hepburn, Shotokan Karate Centre, 5 Darley Road, Manchester, M16ODG.
Kung Fui. From out of the East comes a taste of a new way of life. Kung Fui. Kung Fui in bacon and mushroom flavor. Crisp. Crunchy. Kung Fui. The smashing new snack from Golden Wonder.
Bonjour, comment allez-vous?
Hola, buenos días, ¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo?
Kawasaki Juukou no teikyou de ookuri shimasu.
Enoeda Keinosuke-san to Reiko-fujin ga London no kōgai ウィンザー城を訪れたのは、涼しい秋の風がそろそろ立ち始めようとする頃であった。ロンドンから34キロ、堅牢で美しいこの城は、11世紀にウィリアム王が築いたもので、850年にわたるイギリス王室の居城である。江上さん夫妻は結婚1年半、まだ新婚の甘さがある。2人はしっかりと手を握り合って見物していた。
いや、僕は本当にそう思いました。夫婦だったらですね、手をつないでですね、くぐらいのそのあれがあっていいと思いますね。これは本当にいいことだと思います。
おばあさんやおじいさんでも手をつないで歩いてますね。ああいうのすごく見てて微笑ましい。
あれはいいと思いますね。
おばあさんになってもその習慣だけは、うん、やろうと思ってます。やってほしいです。
なるとね、今はやってますね。時々自分でハッと気がつきますけどね。
Enoeda Kenosuke 35歳、空手道6段、汗まみれの顔は気迫に満ち、怒鳴るような掛け声は弟子たちに一瞬の気の緩みも与えない。彼が空手の先生としてここイギリスに腰を落ち着けたのは5年前のことであった。高校の3年生で空手の洗礼を受け、大学卒業後日本で後進の指導に当たっていた江上さんは、昭和36年の全日本選手権で3位になり、翌年は2位、昭和38年の選手権では優勝と、トントン拍子に第一人者への道を進んだ。その後昭和40年、正しい空手を広めるためヨーロッパ各地を回り、途中立ち寄ったイギリスに居ついてしまった。伝統と栄光の都ロンドン、礼儀を重んじる国と知ってはいたが、住み着いてみてこの国のエチケットのやかましさと気候の悪さに江上さんは抵抗した。
あの気候にも泣きますね。冬になるとほとんどお天道様見ることができません。薄ら寒くてですね、
ドラキュラでも出てしまう。
それだけにああいったそのイングランドのその気質っていうんですか、あのど根性ができたんだと思いますけどね。あんな悪い気候のところに、まあ、
ね、
これだけの帝国がまあ昔からあるんだと思いますけど、だから少し雨がね濡れたって平気な顔してるんですもんね、向こうの人って。
ミニスカートにビートル、伝統の国で古い社会性に逆らうこともイギリス人のど根性と言うべきだろうか。紳士と淑女の国イギリスにも多様化の波は押し寄せている。道場にテレビ局が取材に来た。正しい空手の普及を目指す江上さんにとってまたとないチャンスである。
空手というものが変な空手として紹介されることになるから、もう早い話はですね、ちょっと見せてお金を取って、でそのこの簡単な本でも読めば君はこれだけのことができるようになるんだというような、その非常なそのまやかしものが流行ってたわけです。で本当の空手を今ですね見せないとあと大変なことになるということになって回ったわけです。その反響は非常に大きなもんで、結局我々が帰れない理由になったんですけど。 What are you going to do there, Dad? Right. Do you want to... Yeah. Can Mr. Noida...
Enoeda さんの住むアパートはロンドン市内から車で30分、リッチモンドの閑静な住宅街にある。武骨一点張りの Enoeda さんの家にも色とりどりの花が美しく咲き誇っている。もっぱら玲子さんの丹精の賜物である。ある日友人の家族が訪ねてきてティータイムが始まった。イギリスを滅ぼすお茶の時間と皮肉られるほどイギリス人はお茶好きだ。どんなに忙しい時でも紅茶を飲む暇だけはきちんと作る。Enoeda さんと結婚するためこの国に来た玲子さんはこうした風習にようやく慣れた。
私が結婚してイングランドに参りますとき、彼とは一度も父母は会っておりませんし、ただ電話の声とか手紙ぐらいでしたけど、お前の選んだ人だったら大丈夫だろうということで行かせてくれましたけど、父も母もやっぱりすごく心配してたようです。
それとあの空手のね先生当たりでね、そのというそのあれがあったと思うんです。
そうです、
ね、それも無理はないと思いますけど、
足一本で手一本っていうのはもう食べられなくなりますもんね。
後片付けはいつも住み込みの弟子イギリスの青年たちが手伝う。
3人おりますけど、すごく純粋無垢のような感じがします。なんか、ほがらかで、置いていてても全然居候なんていう気もしませんし、楽しいです、いてくださった方が。それに、英語の勉強にもなりますし、なんかすごく彼を崇拝しているのか、その信じきっていて、もう尊敬してるようですね。で、それからあの先生の奥さんだということで、いたわってくれてるんじゃないかと思います。二層論ですから、そういう気兼ねもあるんじゃないかと思いますけど、私あの主人と結婚して初めて空手を見ました。それまではもうすごい野蛮なものだと誤解してました。であの今現在は見るのすごく好きです。ですからあの道場なんかへ時々行っては拝見しております。
9月のある日、市内の道場に稽古着姿のイギリス人たちが緊張した表情で集まった。日本で初めて開かれる世界空手道大会に派遣する英国チームの選考会である。
はい、
Enoeda さんも3人の居候を出場させた。この日のために彼は3人を嫌というほどしごいてきた。
気ごきということよりもですね、武道でありですね、特殊なそのスポーツだと。で、その練習たるやにその苦しむんだということをね、初めからその案に知っておるんですね。またそれに対する期待もあるわけです。だから逆に日本でね、パツに持っていたそのしごきかけるとその文句言われるけど、向こうの方がそういった点じゃやりいいんじゃないかと思います。でもんで、ただその、スポーツ的にね、技術だけを据えるということじゃもう絶対にダメですね。
じゃあ、
Mr. Knighton。
居候の中から2人が前衛チームの一員に選ばれた。Enoeda家の朝食では彼一人がいつも日本食である。
あの彼はもう全然ダメなんです、西洋料理は。でも朝からご飯、夜もご飯ぐらいご飯が好きなんです。
僕の場合は本当にダメなんです。ご飯を食べないとですね、いくらの干物をね腹いっぱい食べてもどうなんだからもう食べたような気がしないもんです。もう本当に我慢ができなくなってきてですね。
10月10日、東京九段の日本武道館。Enoeda さんはこの大会に監督としてイギリスチームを率いて乗り込んだ。5年ぶりの帰国であった。スタンドには初めて顔を合わせた玲子さんのお母さんも姿を見せた。 リスチームはインドネシアとアメリカを倒し準々決勝へと勝ち進んだ。この試合でイギリスチームは4対0で日本に敗れ去ったが、その活躍は日本の空手界にも警鐘を打ち鳴らした。その夜、Enoedaさんは愛弟子2人と連れ立って夢にまで見た焼き鳥屋ののれんをくぐった。
いやもう本当に美味しいですね。もう今だからね、8キロ太りました。僕帰りました。寿司よりも焼き鳥の方がうまいもんですよ、本当に。でも彼がで本当にうまいって言ってましたよ。だからね、もう本当にうまいそうです。向こうに行ってやれば早いんじゃないですかね。
8キロも太ってしまって再びイギリスに戻ったEnoedaさんは早速トレーニングを始めていた。
我々としては絶対に一度もね負けてはならないということは、一ついいところをねここにやらしたとかっていうことになりますとですね、